time for Pants, and Pants was on FranLab.
Okay, here we got something that you may have never seen before. But these were very popular in the early part of the 20th century, and they really were, for a lot of people, the first portable ink pens that they would buy. And these were glass-tipped fountain pens. You don't see them much these days, for some good reasons. One is that these were not collectible pens. These were very introductory-level pens. They were inexpensive. This one, the barrel and the cap, are made of molded nitrocellulose, which is very popular in the early part of the 20th century for making lightweight, inexpensive parts. But nitrocellulose is very prone to coming apart and cracking, and it doesn't really resist wear very well, so a lot of these pens don't survive. But even more so, the reason you don't see many of these glass-tipped pens is because they all pretty much shared the same fate. At some point, they would get dropped on the floor and the tips would shatter. And this one is not immune to that. The very tip has been chipped off and there's a little sharp edge. So once you would break off the really nice, rounded, smooth tip, it really wouldn't write well anymore. And you would probably toss it out. And if you were gonna toss out this pen, you probably wouldn't buy another glass tip pen. You'd probably graduate up to an actual metal quill fountain pen. And big difference between these two. Metal nib fountain pens, kind of see here, it's a very complicated arrangement of vents and flutes that very carefully control the flow of air going up through the pen into the reservoir and regulating the ink flowing down to the tip through the nib. These type of pens, it's very hard to regulate the ink, and this kind of complexity made these pens very expensive until like the mid-20th century, when mass production and cheaper materials made them pretty much affordable for anyone. But in the early days, these really elegant and very simple glass nib pens were the choice. There's no complicated airflow mechanism. This pen is very simple. It just has a little rubber bladder in it, and although the filling mechanism is broken, you would have turned this little ring away, and then a little lever would have popped out, and when you would pull up on the lever, it would compress the bladder, which is a little rubber balloon, and by compressing the bladder, it would force the air out through the tip. And so you would have this submerged in an inkwell. You'd pull out the lever, it would squeeze out the air, and then when you pop the lever back in, the bladder would return to its regular shape, and in the process it would draw the ink up into the reservoir, and then you'd write with it. Like I said, this one has a chipped tip. You can kind of see it there. Get the reflection where you can see the chip. So it has a very rough writing tip now. I mean, I could buff that out with some buffing compound and a buffing rag. Could take the sharp edge off, which I might do later. Even though the internal filling mechanism is broken, it does still write. And with the cap on, you can see about the portability. It's pretty comparable to like a modern mini Sharpie. You know, it's about comparable in size. And these glass nib pens, they would typically write a fairly broad line. They were not very fine tipped, and you didn't have the level of ink control that a regular fountain pen would have, so it would tend to deliver a lot of ink, and so the kind of line that you would get for writing with a pen like this would be very similar to what you get with a modern felt tip marker, Sharpie. It'd be a broad line, a deep line, a lot of ink. But, you know, for children and, you know, college students and, you know, just as a pen that would be almost disposable in the sense that if you were to drop this pen, break it, or if you were to lose it, it wouldn't break the bank. Whereas with fountain pens in the early 20th century were extremely expensive and not the kind of thing that you'd ever want to lose or have fall out of your pocket. So, but let's take a look at if I can get a line written here. We'll need an inkwell. And I have to find the part of the tip where it's not really coarse, so here we go. Okay. Yeah. Now this is writing a rather sharp line because the tip has been broken. it wouldn't have had that sharp a line in its original state. It would have been a little broader, probably more like that. That would be like a little bit closer to where it would have been originally. So, but, you know, these do work, and like I said, they were simple and inexpensive and very popular, although you wouldn't really know it these days by the fact that they're kind of rare. But yeah, these little glass nib pens are still a thing of beauty, and you know, I wish they would still make them. You can get some kind of glass nibbed dipping pens, but I don't know of anyone making the glass nibbed fountain pens anymore. I'll have to look into that. But yeah, these were very popular back in the day, and still a piece of art that you can write with. Alright, well that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks too to everyone down there in Patreon making all these videos possible, including these pen and pencil videos. So thank you, everybody on the Patreon. Alright, I'm Fran. I'll be back doing something else real soon. Woo! In my life.